the world champion. She can now start thinking about being the Olympic champion. And the challenge wasn't coming from Julie Furtado, but from another American, Susan DiMattei. Susan DiMattei of the United States, followed by Alison Sider of Canada, and then came Norway's Dahle.
Good girl, Susan. Good girl. Good girl, bottle. Good girl, you're looking great, Susan. There!
Alison Sider pushed on. She was down by 2 minutes, but had the knowledge that in the pre-Olympic race here, there were 11 flat tires on the final lap. Plus, if the heat could take down Julie Furtado, it could certainly do a number on Paolo Pezzo.
Paolo Pezzo, though, was showing no signs of effect from the heat or the sun, or indeed making a mistake technically. She was riding this course like she knew every inch of the way. Susan DiMattei, she was on a dream machine today. She hadn't put a wheel wrong. It was all working out for her. She was riding like the American should have ridden all week. She was riding with determination. The same couldn't be said of Julie Furtado. Furtado was now in distress. She was no longer a competitor in this race. She was thinking only of survival. Temperature now 91 degrees. The heat was important to everybody. Could they survive it? It seemed the woman from Italy could.
Alison Sider was chipping away at Pezzo's lead. What was once 2 minutes was now under, and that was certainly cause for optimism. Anytime a cyclist can maintain a pace that prevents someone from catching up, they're doing their job, and that was Susan DiMattei.
Paolo Pezzo was heading for goal now as she approached the finish arena. The full distance was almost behind her. And behind her, too, by a minute, was Alison Sider, the favorite.
And 45 seconds behind her was Susan DiMattei. The medals had been decided.
In the past 6 miles, Sider had closed in by almost a minute, but the move had come too late.
Susan DiMattei could now hear what Pezzo and Sider could, the glorious sound of the fans at the finish.
Paolo Pezzo arrives in the arena and waves to the crowd, the first Olympic champion of mountain biking among the women. She had covered the course in just short of 2 hours, and for the majority of that time, she'd been alone.
With the gold zipped up, the search for information was on. What exactly happened out there? One thing we found out was that Paolo Pezzo was injured in that crash, and even tougher than we thought. There's no doubt that Alison Sider had dreams of gold, but as she came across the finish line, it looked as though she didn't care what color it was. She was 107 behind Pezzo, and 38 seconds behind Sider came Susan DiMattei. And if ever a bronze medal looked like a gold, this was it.
Susan DiMattei, face it or not, had been a surprise. She'd ridden her heart out, she'd ridden for the United States, she'd ridden for her husband-to-be, and she got the result.
And you wonder if from her fiancé, the course designer David Weens, Susan DiMattei didn't get a little secret one night over dinner. Because this wasn't the way it was supposed to end. This was supposed to be the embrace for Julie Furtado at the finish line. But many miles ago, we learned that Julie didn't have what it took to withstand the heat and the pressure of the race today. She said before it began, maybe it would be better if I wasn't the favorite. After this, she may not have that problem for a while. Elsewhere in the American camp was someone as happy as you might expect.
I am absolutely so thrilled, and please, the people here were so great. I mean, it gave me chills when I was riding, and it's really nice to do it here in the USA. I was hot, and a few times I felt like my head was going to explode, but I think everybody did.
I couldn't deal with the heat. The heat just, it killed me. And I tried to come back, but I just about had heat stroke, so I'm really disappointed because I tried to prepare for the heat, and I think my fitness was good because I felt my legs felt great, but then I just after the first lap I just thought I was going to explode from the heat.
These are the three names that will always be linked to the premiere, the Olympic beginning of mountain biking. There won't be another first time. Petso, Sider, and DiMattei. All of Petso's credentials, a former world championship, made this first ever goal cherished, but no surprise. That Julie Furtado's body said no is one. And that's only the first American eye-opener. 4 weeks ago, Susan DiMattei didn't even know if she'd be here. So you really can't say this was a dream. Because to be honest, she shouldn't have even dared. But she did. And that's what Olympians are made of.
This was one of the
swim team complete with